bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall always in my heart. These words of the psalmist ring out in my heart today as I recall my occasion, my response to God's call. I was born in a devout family of Our Lady of Dolors Church, Bela of Mangalore Diocese, which is situated in Kasaragod district of Kerala state. My parents are Mr. Luis de Souza and Elise Rodriguez. Along with my parents and siblings Shanti and Jason, I was privileged to experience the love and care of my grandparents, uncles, aunts and cousins, being a part of joint family. My family was indeed a cradle of love and faith. We used to pray the prayer for occasions every day during the evening prayer, and this aspect has played a significant role in the journey of my occasion. I had my basic studies at St. Bartholomew School, Bela, of Charity Sisters. Those sisters have influenced me a lot regarding my occasion. Since my childhood, I was fascinated by science. I often used to question and reason out everything. This attitude made me to question even the aspects which we believe in faith, such as the creation account given in the Bible. The Bible says this universe was created by God, but science explains it differently. This caused some confusion in my mind. I used to reflect over these aspects and sought the answers in the basis and the light of the Word of God. As I completed my 10th standard, I was thinking, what next? Then I felt that God has a plan for me. I was really confused. What is happening to me? What is this? Then I felt that God is calling me in the deep down of my heart. I expressed this desire to my parents. Even they too were shocked. It was quite unexpected for them too. They agreed, but with a condition that to take sufficient time to decide and discern my call and to continue my studies first. According to their opinion, I did my PUC in Science Stream at Government College, Kumla, then my BSc at Kendra College, Mangalore, and my B.Ed at Srinivas College, Mangalore, where I was awarded as the best outgoing student. Though I felt God's call within me when I was just a student of 10th standard, it took 6 long years to respond to it and to join a religious congregation. This path was not at all easy for me. During my studies, I was very much busy with my studies and could not focus much on my occasion. Very especially during BSc and B.Ed, I had to travel all the way from Kasaragod to Mangalore every day by train. In order to manage my time and this busy schedule, I used to do my homework in train itself, which was a tough task for me. Though, because of the grace of God and the continuous support of my parents, brother and sister, I could continue and complete my studies effectively. The sacrifice, the support and the love of my parents and my siblings was simply incredible. Being a simple girl of the world, I was supposed to be like any other young girls in the world. I enjoyed my life to the fullest with my friends in the college and outside. As soon as we were completed the B.Ed, all of us friends were discussing about our future plan. Some of them have told that they want to join a good job, some wanted to do their higher studies, and some of them wanted to enter into the marital life. They asked me, "Shalma, what about you?" Then I said, "I want to be a religious." They were shocked. Then my friends told, "What are you speaking? Are you mad?" I did not tell anything to them and to the lecturers, who told that it is my wrong decision and they are sad with my decision. Then I started to think by myself, can I really give up all these pleasures, mobile, social media, money and my will, the freedom, the lethargic life which I have? I said, no, I cannot. At times when I was disturbed and distracted, just before going to bed, I prayed in tears to God to strengthen me to remain faithful to Him forever. And At that moment, I didn't know anything about personal prayer or discernment process, yet I did it effectively with the grace of God. During those 6 years, I felt that it was the best period of my formation where God Himself was my formator. As I was teaching at St. Teresa School, Beltangadi, I felt that now teaching is my profession. I want to make it as my mission, where I can give Christ to my students and to the people with whom I live and to whom I serve. This has strengthened my vocation and instilled within me a deepest desire to commit myself to God. As soon as I completed this teaching at St. Teresa School, Beltangadi, I once again told my parents that I wanted to be a religious. Then they agreed and told my cousin sister, Sister Shalini D'Souza, who is an Ursuline Franciscan sister, and through her, I joined the Ursuline Franciscan congregation. After the formation in my religious congregation, I committed myself as a religious sister on April 5th of 2018. I feel privileged to share about my congregation. Ursuline Franciscan congregation was founded in the year 1887 on April 10th, Easter Sunday, by Father Urbanstein S.J. at Holy Rosary Cathedral, Mangalore. In accord with the charism, we the Ursuline Franciscan sisters launch into the lives of the people through the spirituality of relationship of Saint Angela Merici, the spirituality of kenosis of Saint Francis of Assisi, and the spirituality of discernment of our founder, Father Urbanstein S.J. We mainly carry out the apostolates such as education, pastoral care, health care, and social work. Apart from this, we also engage in the ministries such as prison ministry, anti-child trafficking, Domestic Helpers Movement of India, animating the self-help groups, etc. Through all these ministries, the sisters of our congregation meet the needs of the poor people and try for the upliftment of the downtrodden. Our congregation has 5 provinces, namely Mangalore, Mysore, Hubli, North and Northeast. We also render our service in the foreign countries such as Africa, USA, Germany, and Italy. At present, our congregation is headed by the effective leadership of Reverend Sister Sushila Siquera, our Superior General. The life of the Ursuline Franciscan sisters is marked by simplicity and hospitality. I love my congregation, and I'm happy and feel proud to be a Ursuline Franciscan sister. Dear friends, amidst the allurements of the world, the number of boys and girls responding to God's call is declining. The noise of the world is not allowing the young minds to respond to the call of God. Dear friends, quieten yourself. Sit before the Lord in silence and try to listen to His voice. If you hear the gentle voice of a Lord saying you, come and follow me, never hesitate to say yes, because one who has called you will hold your hand and walk with you forever and remain faithful to you forever.